You're now listening to Sleep Time's Over.
Sleep time is over, baby.
Listen up, everybody, as you tune to this podcast. Sleep time's over, come closer to get the raw facts. Zach Moore's hosting on the show, for sure. Yeah. Reporting live from Jawai, that's a dog, you know. Talking reminiscing about the good old days in the now. Sipping on that old fashioned at the room at Hi Brau. We on location worldwide, on your stereo deck. On your phone, on the pad, but guaranteed all fresh. Reviewing music and the nuisance that the media miss. But got the blueprint with the newness that the people will take. Good old America ain't ready for that island of slang. Sleep time is over. Give a toast up to the rest of the gang. To your tribe or the vibe or the click on the mission. Suggest you dive cause we live on transmission. Listen, listen, he got the voice that got the locals on vote. Zach Moore's from mayor, but for now, lock it in.
Sleep time's over. Somebody lock the doors, cause we got ourselves a chicken fight. Some meat between the buns. Also live performance from one of my favorites, the Kamaaina Classic, I.A. Ladies and gentlemen, we got the sommelier to the stars. This is Sky Cameron. I'm the ones and twos and threes and fours and everything in between. DJ Freeze, your host tonight. DJ Zach Moore.
Just a reminder, besides the Christmas festivities going on, we have the chicken. We have to address.
First of all, the Lord Flores, everyone, ladies and gentlemen, yes. But it is the Christmas episode. We got to make do of this. You know, all this chicken battling, all these people talking shit. You know, you got these tall howlies yelling. One lady that I don't know if she's going to make it. I hope she's going to make it. Smith & King's Samantha Moore will possibly be here as well. I got this jacket. I just realized I didn't take the tag off. The jacket, which is a street thing that we do. We keep it on so you can return it. Gosh, when did I get this thing? This is $59.99.
Holy
on
shit.
Clearance. On clearance for $23.
Hey.
So, see, I remember when I got this thing. Sky, you into the Christmas attire here?
Eh.
I'm gonna yeah, exactly. I'm sweating profusely before I put this on, and this is already a problem. All right, so once again, last show of the year.
That's right.
147 is the episode of this one, the program that we do, Sleep Time's Over. Shout out to everybody on the Spotify, iTunes, watching us in the 4K on the YouTube, and all that good stuff. And got back from, we took a week break last week, because I went on what the old people call a trip. I went on a plane ride. First time in 4 years, this guy.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, last year I went to Dallas for a Titans game, but that was like a weekend. That doesn't really count. But like, you know, this was like over 10 days.
This was a real
days.
Vacation.
Vacation.
Like right? A week and a half? What was it, 10
this
days?
This was about 10 days. This was 10 days. Went to New York, went to Nashville, went to Houston, just got back from Houston last night. So.
Looked like an epic trip, man. Planning saw the chicken. Clips
yeah,
on
exactly.
IG.
So just, you know, New York, you just go there, you eat, drink. And then with this here, if you guys can see, smoke. It was going to happen, right? We're going to talk with smoke. We got the dark beta thing. So that's what you're doing in New York. You go out every night. You're drinking, eating. That's all you're doing. Your IG story, everything, right? And then went to Nashville. Went to see a Titans game. Went to visit friends out in New York. Went to visit friends out in Nashville. Then went out to Houston. Went out to Houston for a day. And then watched the Rockets. And some observations for being a person that doesn't travel often.
Okay.
I just want to throw that out there. Everybody's really nice. New York, I tell you what. I mean, it was a small little example to give you all for 10 days. Or it was a week in New York. But everybody's friendly. Everybody's respectful. Everybody's saying thank you. Everybody's saying excuse me. Everybody's saying pardon me. I don't know if I get that here. You know. And then you have the conforming New York fast lifestyle where everybody's moving, right? Everybody's got to go.
Right.
Everybody's going on subway. Everybody's walking fast. If you fall down, they'll pick you up, but then you got to go, right?
It's not like over here. Everyone's walking around slow, looking up.
Slow, looking
around.
Right. Exactly. So it's kind of the machine of New York that it kind of conforms you whether or not. So it's interesting how everybody moves the same way. The cars are hectic. Everybody's hectic, but nobody falls down. There's no car accidents.
There's a rhythm to the city.
There's a rhythm to the city. That's got to be a song, right?
Hey.
So then that's the thing that I noticed with New York, Nashville. Everybody says hi to you. Everybody's saying howdy. Everybody's saying what's up to you. Houston the same way. So it's just interesting that we're dealing with friendly people as everybody's getting like killed in Hawaii. What's going on over here, man? Everybody dying over here. I don't understand what's going on. People getting stabbed, shot, killed, or hurt. Hey, you. It's Arrested Development. Sorry. It was a song from
ongoing. Song
Jimmy Taco knows
on
that song.
Show.
Shout out Jimmy Taco. Yeah, I got it. Yes, but just was wondering. You know, it was a big contrast of what's been going on as far as the trip goes. And another thing that I have to shout out to all the women that are fans of the channel that they all know and love in this holiday season, the Hallmark Channel.
What is that?
Any fans of the Hallmark Channel?
You know, I didn't even know what that was until I met you and your wife.
You know,
I didn't know that was even a thing.
Let me tell you this, all right? As you, I remember you saying that, or you thought there's like a channel of like talking about greeting cards or something, which I might watch that one, but it's not. It's great Christmas movies, 24 hours a day, starring the likes of the irrepressible Candace Cameron Bure, formerly of Full House. She is the top grossing actress on this channel.
What do you mean grossing? Like advertising?
She's making cash. She's making money.
Tide is spending the most money.
She sold
on
the rights. I looked this up. Like, she sold the rights.
I don't
to
get
Full
it.
House. She's got the money to Full House. She's got the Netflix deal. She's right. Making the money.
All right.
Shout out Candace Cameron Bure and shout out to Lacey Chabert.
Right. A party
shout
of
out
five
Party Five. Theme. Lacey Chabert still working. So I wanted
wow,
to look.
We're really skimming the D list here, right?
Well, speaking of D's. We got Dean Cain on there. good tie in there, Sky. And we got him on there. We have, what was that guy? Somebody from the Baywatch. One of those guys from Baywatch.
Yeah.
David Charvet is probably on there. One of those guys. Some of Charvet, Lacey Chabert. Lacey Chabert making I looked this up. She makes $1.5 million a year.
Doing Hallmark movies.
Doing the Hallmark Channel. Yes.
Yeah, it looks like
Candace Cameron Bure making $5 million a year.
Wow.
She is the top grosser.
What was the last movie you can remember with on the Hallmark Channel that you watch?
Like the Christmas Plumber or like the Christmas Mechanic.
Christmas Plumber?
Or like the Christmas Wish. It's the same plot. She's a gal on the go. She's a businesswoman, but she's stressed. And it just happens to be holiday time. So she needs to have a break. So one of her BFFs decides, hey, why don't you come with me to the town? And we go hang out in the town. And then we'll just unwind. So then they unwind. They go to this magical town.
Okay.
And then she meets, of course, a magical guy who's like a plumber, who's like a mechanic, or a stockbroker usually. It's like some clean-cut alley guy. And it's like, he's probably a stockbroker. And then they talk to each other. But then the BFF has a brother, and then the brother is trying to get with her. So she must decide which Christmas love to have.
Wow.
That's the plot for
like
every single
dream.
Movie.
Not only is she has two men fighting over her, she got men fighting that can fix shit.
Right. There's one that can fix, and then there's one that's like private school, public school battle. And then they're trying to see who's going to take take her love. But they fight like nicely. There's no violence in the Hallmark Channel. But they'll say stuff like passive aggressively. They'll be like, okay, yeah, and then they'll smile.
Unlike the Lifetime channel, which is
well, Lifetime that leads that's domestic violence. Yes,
that leads to
yeah, very strange, very awkward situation. You know, there's some slaps going on in there. But yes, not on the Hallmark Channel. Everybody's happy. Everybody's a freeze. You watch the Hallmark Channel.
Hell no, bro. Like I'm not gonna trust any of your reviews ever again.
Well.
Right, it's the Christmas Plumber.
Oh my God.
Stay tuned for the Christmas special. Freeze and I are going to watch Hallmark Channel. We're going to just watch it.
No.
And then we'll just critique it. It's a thing, man.
Christmas Plumber, my ass.
I tell you what, check it out. You got the Christmas Banker, you got the Christmas Stockbroker, you got it all. It's a month to month, every month. Christmas in July, of course, all the gals, they love the Christmas in July. And it's Hallmark Channel.
So, how many of these are you actually sitting through and watching the entire thing?
Well, you see. When you're traveling, right, you're traveling in these Airbnbs, as they call it, and you don't really know what kind of cable or television they have. So this one Airbnb had like four channels, and strangely, it did not have Hallmark Channel, but it had Criminal Minds, which is another one. The women love Criminal Minds, and they just love it. And there's that one guy that used to be funny, but he's on there, and he's like really serious now. Who's the guy on Criminal Minds? Name the actors of Criminal Minds.
I don't know them. One guy on Criminal
Shamar
Minds.
Shamar Moore. Is he on that show? I don't know. Hey, all right.
Oh, hey, there you go.
He's not the funny one. But then we had that. And then the next trip over, then that's when the Hallmark Channel movies started pumping in. And Lifetime were pumping in the Christmas movies. And it's all the same plot.
Right.
So, FYI, for the people that don't know of the Hallmark Channel, you do now. And don't forget to tune in. Because it's all
yeah, they need
day
that
long.
Plug.
Yes, great.
Let's buy Candace Cameron a new car, another car.
Get ready to see Dean Cain and Lacey Chabert. Lacey Chabert's still looking good, though. She's still looking good. I don't know how she's probably 30. And the Cameron Bray, she's like religious, so like, you know, who knows what kind of, you know, surgery she does, but, you know, related to Kirk Cameron.
Wow.
They're heavily religious. I'm just saying. Kirk Cameron's out of his mind.
I don't know if Candace is as fanatical.
I think she's not as crazy as Kirk Cameron, but she's there. She's the moneymaker, obviously. So that was, to sum up my trip, the Hallmark Channel.
Wow.
So, yeah. And on top of that, we got, we got to talk about this chicken sandwich thing now. Like, it's all coming to an end. You know, we have months and months, people talking shit. They're saying things on the IG, you know, calling people out. They're adding people, you know. And it's the same time. We have something else coming to an end. Is this franchise over here. We got the Star Wars people. All the Star Wars people, they're all pissed off. All the nerds, virgins coming out of the woodwork, coming out of the parents' basement. They've stopped. Here's another recurring thing that goes on, Freeze, is the masturbation. They don't masturbate. They're going to go watch Star Wars, Rise of Skywalker. This. And what do you think, Sky?
You
all the critics are coming out. And they're all pissed off. And what's going to happen? The movie comes out Thursday as we record Wednesday.
Well, there's the screenings tonight that are all sold out, right? You're going to watch it just on tonight, Saturday. Right. I'm watching it on Saturday.
Right.
It's the worst reviewed movie right now as far as the reviews are coming out. It's the worst reviewed Star Wars movie since Phantom Menace. I don't know. They're crapping on it. I mean,
well, it's the most polarizing fan base, as we've talked about before,
exactly,
of all time. You cannot satisfy this group of people.
Right.
It's 40 years.
Right.
So you have people our age, you have people younger, you have people even older than us, and they just can't be satisfied regardless. And I don't know what's going to happen. Freeze, are you a Star Wars fan?
Bro, I don't know why you even referenced me about masturbation and
Star Wars. Good segue.
Wait a minute. I'm going to say this. I'm going to clear this up right now.
No, that's been on my mind. I know I heard your question, but bro, what the hell? Why was I referenced for that part?
That's honest of you, all right? Because every time I say the word masturbation on the show, I know what you're doing behind me, all right? You put your hands up like this, okay? I'm not calling you out, okay? I'm not.
That's true. I just did it again.
You do. I watch this thing, and you do this thing. So I'm just saying, in a reference to you, Freeze, I'm saying the word again. So if you're going to do this, you can do it.
I know. I just don't beat off
the
Star Wars.
This has nothing to do with you, okay?
I beat off the other shit, not Star
Let me tell you something. The people, you're fine, okay? You're fine. You're good.
But I watch Star Wars, but I am not a mega fan.
All right, that's fair enough.
That was the answer, sorry.
Okay, that's good. Well, a lot of people are, and they're going to go tonight.
Yep.
It starts tonight?
Starts tonight.
Tonight's Wednesday, right?
Tomorrow, excuse me. Was it Thursday?
Tomorrow?
Thursday night shows.
Okay.
Thursday night shows,
all right.
7 o'clock.
So then that shout out to our special Star Wars, speaking of nerds, we're going to be doing the Star Wars special this Sunday?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
What are we going to do?
God.
So drinking Powerade, eating Hot Pockets. And
a lot of Hot Pockets. Totinos. Yeah, we'll get all that stuff ready.
Twitch,
yeah. A lot of people on Twitch are going to be watching that one. Well, so there's that going on. Sky, what about you're the movie guy. So for the people
speaking of sequels that sucked, I saw the new Jumanji movie.
Oh, God. Jesus Christ.
That one sucked. Yeah, sorry. Sorry, The Rock.
No, Dwayne, you got to cut it out. How many...
Jumanji the Next Level, right? It was the sequel to that, the last one they did, right? Jumanji Welcome to the Jungle.
Got it.
I thought that first one was not bad. I actually kind of enjoyed it, that, right?
I've never seen it. I didn't see the Robin Williams one. I didn't see any of
these. The Robin Williams
Williams all right?
It's okay, I guess. I like this one, actually. It revamped the series. I thought it actually was better than that original.
Oh, really?
Right. But then this new one feels forced. It just lacks the humor. Just doesn't have the cleverness of the last one. It's
how long
feels
is the
flat.
Movie?
We saw it 2.5 hours.
That's too long of a
movie. It's like 2 hours, 10 minutes.
No, forget it. Can't do it.
And then they immediately set up for another sequel right at the end. No spoilers or anything, but
yeah,
but you know, that's what they're trying to do with these, right?
All right.
How long is The Rock going to stay at the top of the box office?
He's making all the money.
Are anybody in the audience getting tired of The Rock?
People, fans of Dwayne Johnson.
Everyone just loves The Rock. They can watch
it. He went to Washington Intermediate. All right. So, then to McKinley. Okay.
Lacking a little range, I feel. You know.
He should run for president, huh?
I think so.
Why not? We'll talk to Ashley Nagaoka about.
But two mics on that one for me, man.
All right.
I watched Watchmen on HBO.
Okay, so how's that one?
I think it's one of the best shows of the year.
That got a lot of good reviews.
And
right?
It's the weirdest show of the year. I can't believe that made it on HBO because it's so strange and so bizarre.
Right.
So original that I'm kind of blown away that they got away with it.
the movie was pretty hit or miss for a lot of people, right?
Yeah, but this has no connection to the movie. It's more of a direct sequel to the graphic novel. But if you're really into something bold and different,
yeah,
I highly recommend it. It's awesome. It'll make my top five TV series of the year.
How many episodes are we looking at?
Nine episodes. All right, 1 hour episodes.
That's doable. How long an episode?
1 hour episodes.
That's pushing it. Okay. All right, what else you watch?
And then that's it for watching. Oh, I went and saw Jack White and the Raconteurs, and I'm not a big, like...
The who?
Jack White. You know Jack White of the White Stripes?
Jack White is a snowboarder? Oh, no.
Yes.
Sorry.
Sean White. Right. Different guy. But, I don't know. He's arguably, you know, one of the great guitarists working today, right? So I saw him at the Republic, and it was a pretty amazing show. I'm not a big rock show guy, but that was...
Yeah, what are you doing at a rock concert?
Hey, man. Gotta expand my mind. There's no hip hop shows Grouch and Murs are coming.
Hip hop's
right?
on a lull right now. What's the name of the group?
The Raconteurs.
The Raconteurs. Okay, because I'm looking at this. It looks like Rocketeer or some shit. Okay, Raconteurs. I got it.
So yeah, you are a fan of The Rock then.
It was actually one of the best concerts I've seen this year. It was really good. What was that?
He said, "Are you a fan of The Rock because you're a fan of the Raconteurs?" Where's the rim shots? Okay, forget it. Forget it. Okay, so. Okay, you got a busy.
Well, speaking of music, I just wanted to ask you really quick. You don't seem like the big holiday guy. Do you like listen to holiday music?
Well, like
do you listen
days
to
off.
Christmas music? Do you have a go-to Christmas song or Christmas album?
Well, let's just be frank here, okay? Do we really enjoy these songs? Are we really truly enjoying these songs? I mean, they come out once a year, or if you're watching Hallmark Channel every day. But do you really truly enjoy these songs?
I enjoy certain Christmas music. Not all, but certain ones.
Okay, convince me here. What Christmas song would be a song that we can be go to? We can be smiling about and be happy about and like.
What about Feliz Navidad?
That's the starter you're choosing?
I don't know. I'm just saying.
Really?
Shout out to Iglesias. Well, my favorite Christmas album is this Stevie Wonder Christmas. You ever listen to that? From the 60s? It's incredible Christmas album.
It's Stevie Wonder, right. You can't go wrong. But what about like chestnuts roasting and all that? The virgin?
What about Donny Hathaway this Christmas?
Wow, Donny Hathaway. Yeah.
That's a great song. Aretha Franklin has a great Christmas album. I think more of the Motown soul Christmas. I think Jackson 5 have a classic.
That would
Christmas
be automatic,
album.
Right.
I don't know if my wife was buying all the 98 degrees Christmases and
much like every woman between 30 and 35. That's fine. But then, like, what about Neil Sedaka or something, or Neil Diamond?
I don't know. I like also Wham. Last Christmas. What about that song?
That's cool. I mean,
I like that one.
I've played that during my DJing times. Yes, it's fine. But then you got to get out of it like one chorus.
As a hip hop guy, you like Christmas and Hollis from Run DMC, or you think that's the most played out Christmas song?
I can't do it. The beginning is fine, but then you got a one chorus out. That's DJ talk.
I got one.
Taco knows about that chorus out. But yeah, that's about it. I'm not really a fan of these songs, but.
Well. Speaking of, we'll have to poll the crowd. But speaking of polls, we actually did some IG polls today, Christmas surveys.
Yes, it can. Where's our director of social media? Is he here?
Yeah.
Where's he going?
Jay Nads, right next to you.
Jay Nads is a friend of. Oh, right here. Shout out Peripheral Vision. All right. So we have a bunch of IG polls. So let's go down the line. What was the first one we had here? Is Die Hard a Christmas movie?
I thought the first one was the would you rather receive a real gift?
Oh, yeah, let's backtrack. Okay. Would you rather receive a real gift rather than a gift card was the question, right? So let's put out to the crowd. Do you want a real gift or do you want a gift card?
Well, let's say a real gift that you might not use.
A real gift you might not use. Well, that's kind of swaying then a little
bit. I mean, well.
Well, see, you can't say that in a poll. That's a good.
See, the biggest complaint, right, is like they say people say gift cards have no thought, and so they're like, well, at least I'm getting another gift and it has thought.
Right.
So, what do you want? A gift with thought that you don't use, or a gift card?
Right.
I want a thought.
Well, let's go. What did the people of the Instagram said? What was the poll?
86% said gift card.
What does the crowd here vote with? Gift card or
take the money and run? That's it.
Gift card. All right.
Visa gift card works. Zippy's gift card. Sam's Club. Longs. It's fine.
Thought for Christmas.
Did you know that it's like Starbucks, like 20% of Starbucks profits are gift cards that are bought and not used?
Well, they're making, they're laughing. Huh?
Yeah, like never, millions and millions of dollars.
I've never received one of those, but let's go with question two. Question two is the Die Hard question.
Yes, so is Die Hard a Christmas movie?
The movie Die Hard with Bruce Willis.
Guys,
is this a Christmas movie or not?
Is Die Hard a Christmas movie?
There we go. I got it. That's right.
What was the poll?
What we got on the poll here?
74% right, says yes, Die Hard is a Christmas movie.
I read an article.
Die Hard Christmas shirt, damn it.
It said the writer of the movie confirmed Frieza. It's a Christmas party. Christmas movie, excuse me.
So, Frieza, are you a fan of the Die Hard movie? All right. So, that's on point. So, we're all in agreement there. Next one is the... Do you actually enjoy participating in Secret Santa with coworkers?
Yes.
Really, Taco? Wow.
How about the crowd? Does the crowd enjoy Secret Santa with your coworkers?
I was gonna say no, right? I mean, no.
We're gonna
Taco. That's a swerve by you. I didn't realize it was gonna.
Jay,
be a
what were the results?
49%
yes, 51 says no.
We'll figure with that. Huh?
Wow, that's right on the fence there.
I mean, do you really want to get Secret Santa? You have to go, and you gotta go like to go to like, you know, Walgreens, or you gotta go to Daiso. Buy some kind of like, you know, placemat, magnet.
Salvation Army.
How are you going to really decide? Taco, I don't know how you figure this out, but how do you go and you figure out what you're going to get the Secret Santa person? Budget of $10. Gift card, that's right.
At work. Oh, there you go.
That's fine. I gave a $25 gift card to... Then that's fine, that's good. See, gift cards, it works. That's fine for the Secret Santa thing. I was going to say white elephant. That's something else. Yeah. So. I don't even know. Okay. What's the next one?
All right. Is being single during Christmas depressing?
Uh-huh.
Yes or no?
No.
Everyone. Hey, all right. Confidence.
We have a resounding no here.
Confidence. That's good. Do you feel happy being single during Christmas, everyone? Is everybody all right? Is everybody happy in general? Is everybody sad?
All right.
Crying? Okay.
Jay, what's the result?
74% said no.
There we go. Confidence
So
wins.
It's not. 74% says no. It's not depressing.
Thomas Ray's the confident man, but yes, he's not single. So yes, I was gonna say, like, do people find Sky? What do you think of this? What do you think of the whole being single during Christmas situation?
Well, me being single at Christmas.
Well, I mean, in general, like, what do we really look at this as something that we hold? I mean, like, suicide is.
Well,
not
you
at
haven't
Christmas,
been
right?
Single I mean, in how many years? Look at that.
Dating or married? You know,
shout out marriage.
Depends. It depends where I go around the town. And I'm just saying, it's just like, do we care? I mean, it's like so much stuff going on. It's a busy time. I don't know if it's really a thing. I mean, I agree with the people saying no, you know? I mean, yeah. Freeze, what do you think of being depressed in Christmas time?
Thanks for asking me that.
I asked Guy first here.
I would take it like 50-50. Like, you can enjoy yourself with somebody and do all kind of fun shit, like go see Shaka Santa, but you can also go see Shaka Santa by yourself.
You can.
It just depends on where you at, you know what I'm saying?
Like,
if you're a depressed person, then you're just going to be sad anyway. Inside
yourself.
Inside, yes, that's right. Confidence. All right, got it. What else we got?
All right.
What's the next one?
And then do you actually drink and enjoy eggnog during the holidays? Yes or no?
People, do you drink the eggnog out there? You guys like eggnog?
Okay, we got a lot of yeses.
Hell yes.
All right.
Hell yes, really?
Jay, what was the results?
31% said yes.
31%
yes.
Said yes.
So that means
69%. 69% finally. The final 69 of 2019 is only fitting for the...
I just don't think Hawaii. Survey. I don't think Hawaii is a big eggnog place.
I tell you, okay, real talk with the eggnog. You're gonna get the carton from. You're gonna get the metal gold carton. You're gonna go pour one for whoever you're drinking this with. If you're not single and depressed, and then you're gonna drink and both drink a cup, and then you're done. It's gonna stay in the fridge, and it's gonna turn, and it's gonna be expired, and that's the end of the damn thing. No one's drinking the whole carton, trying to buy another carton. That's all I'm saying. Sky, are you drinking the whole carton of eggnog?
I've never bought a carton of eggnog.
Good answer. I'm just saying, okay? I'm just saying. Eggnog is not done in large amounts, you know? So maybe we can get an eggnog cocktail. We can get the Lord to
Yeah, maybe
to
the
do
Lord
something.
Will make one.
Yeah, that'll make him happy, wouldn't he?
Well,
yeah. But is that what
I think that's it, man. We're going to move on to this chicken sandwich battle and our special guests.
Yes, I tell you what. For the last show, we got a fun one. We're going to have, finally, the most coveted, most requested female guest ever on this show. on this show.
This is true. This is true.
This is true.
This is true.
From the first time we had, we go back all the way to we had Malika Lincoln on this show.
That's right.
The first feedback we got was not, oh, she's great. When are we going to have Ashley Nagaoka on? So she's going to be coming on later on the show. Yes, give it up, Ashley Nagaoka. Finally. Finally. And then we're going to have the fate of the world is going to be resting on the chicken sandwich battle. Everyone's going to be pins and needles.
Can't wait.
Waiting to see Earl Kakaako, Square Barrels, Smith & Kings. What's going to happen? We got DJ Jimmy Tacos here.
That's right. Woo!
Another guest judge. Ashley Nagaoka is going to be a judge. We're going to pick a special judge from the crowd. A special someone here, don't be shy, is going to be a judge as well. So let's go. Let's take a break and let's get ready for that. Sleep time's over. All right, there we are. Welcome back. And a few news and notes being that this is the last show of the year. Last show of the decade, Scott.
Well, technically we're doing a Star Wars podcast.
Yeah, let's not
forget.
Count that one. But technically this is the last live show at Hi Brau Room.
Yes, it's our last Hi Brau show.
We've got to shout that one out. Shout out the 2010s coming to an end. So that end of the decade doesn't really kind of hit you until, I guess, more recent, going closer to the year. It doesn't really feel like a decade.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like it.
But then we also got to shout out to people, friends of the show, Nick Kurosawa, Otoro.
Hey.
Their new album. Vinyl as well came out. Check this one out. It's actual record.
I'm just going to put this right here. Put in the winner's circle.
It's not time. That's already automatic disqualification from the head Howley in charge. Once again, Thomas Ray. So then we're going to restart with the Farewell to Pint and Jigger show. That's going to be in January.
Right.
We're going to do the show live at Pint and Jigger.
Right.
While they're open. So who knows going to show up on that one.
Yep.
And then in February, the live show from Harry's. Because Harry's is closing as well. So both January
HBD
and February.
Doesn't show up.
Well, yeah, who doesn't show up there? Well, Dave Newman appeared twice. We'll see what happens. Yes.
Oh, but then, Dave Newman.
There we go. Thank you for that.
Got to play the harp every time I mention his name.
And it's only fitting that we end the year out with, once again, the most requested female guest of all time. The men, hopefully they're normal men, have requested her from day one. And it's only fitting we bring her on from Hawaii News Now, Ashley Nagaoka. Where's she at? Biased. So we're blindfolding you for this now. So I don't know what's going to happen, how we're going to do this. How we're going to...
Don't stab yourself with that toothpick.
Who knows what's going to happen? Yeah. Who knows how that's going to be taken care of? But so yes, you really are. I know you're having a hard time believing this.
Why,
but
though?
Because the men, they just
oh,
really
man.
Want to know you. They want to get
okay.
to know you. They're perverted. I don't know. I'm saying.
Perverted.
I'm telling you.
Great.
I'm telling cool. you from day one.
I'm glad
okay.
I'm here.
Shout out to all the women that have been on before that they didn't seem to care about. Malika Lincoln. They're saying, let's bring on Ashley Nagaoka. We bring in Lacey Denise has been on the show. No, where's Ashley Nagaoka? We bring on your good friend. Your good friend, Joe Beth DeVera, was on this show.
Yes.
And all these women are gorgeous women.
Uh-huh.
But still, the men.
What do they say, though?
We want Ashley.
But why?
I don't know.
Oh.
I don't want to go. I don't want to delve too deeply into why. But they're saying
why?
This. So
I'm a
it's just,
I'm curious. I need to know.
Well, we can shout out some people that there was one man that wanted to be here that he's a big fan of yours. He's a big fan of Smith & Kings.
Okay.
It's Spell One. He's a big fan of yours. He was one that was really a voter for so if you could just say shout out to Spell. He's the artist.
Hey.
Artist to the stars. Yeah. Yeah, that's not creepy, but yeah.
Actually, I'm glad we could finally get together.
Thank you for finally being here. Yes. And how you been? How's everything going?
Not bad. It's the holidays. Yep. Kind of crazy, but...
How is it for you in the field that you're in? Do things slow down where things are always going to be consistently going on, right?
In fact, I'm working Christmas Eve, Christmas, New Year's Eve, New Year's. Yeah, there's no holidays in news, so...
Right, exactly.
It's fine.
I got to tell you, what's going on with all these... what's your take on all... Everybody's getting
oh, it's crazy.
Stabbed here. People get stabbed in the face here.
I feel like we're covering a shooting every day. But honestly, you know, it seems like the public, from what I'm seeing just on social media and just talking to people, they really appreciate HPD cracking down. I mean, it's unfortunate that it's, you know, fatal officer-involved shootings. But,
right.
I mean...
And what's going on with these old people stabbing each other in the face? What's going on? In Makiki.
That was a shooting. I mean, 74-year-old.
We got the shooting.
Yeah.
Who got stabbed in the face? Who's the woman? It happened. Yeah. There was a, right? I mean, it's just bizarre. What's going on?
It's. I mean, there was a full moon recently. I don't know if that has
anything
to do with it.
Are you into that? Are you into the whole full moon?
Not really, but retrograde, people say it. No, I don't even know what that means.
Neither do I.
Like, Mercury's in retrograde.
I don't know. Oh. It's all a bunch of hippie shit. But yeah, I don't get it. But speaking of hippies, you're from Kauai. Kauai girl,
yes,
right?
I am.
And
we got
they're there. So I gotta say a shout out on the first time we met. We have to say a shout out to our good
Maddie.
Friend Maddie Kua, bartender, picking the lady.
Yes, he's single, ladies, and he's so
right.
cute.
He's not depressed. Yes, he's a good man.
Yes.
But he was. Did you go to school with him?
I went to high school with him. He was he's a little younger than me, but
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But he's awesome.
Great guy, and that's when we first met, because you guys were, you and Joe Beth.
Yes. That's like a year ago.
This was a year ago, yes. And you were on the other side of the bar, and I see them, and of course, you know, being the local guy that I am, I go to Maddie, and I'm like, oh, so, is that Nagaoka? And then, is that Joe? Oh, is Joe Beth there? Oh, yeah. Oh. Can meet them or what? So that happened, yes, and then luckily, we got Joe Beth on. Yep. Finally, we got you on. Mm-hmm. You're going to be judging chicken.
I can't wait. I didn't eat dinner, so I'm ready.
Oh, see, that's a
sign.
And
I know some people out there might be like, we know you and Sam from Smith and Kings are girls, but I am a fair and unbiased journalist.
Yeah.
I report the facts.
That's what you do. That's the job you do.
Yes.
Right. And you'll be blindfolded.
Speaking of, Joel just came in.
Thank goodness. I was wondering. Samantha Moore is here. She's here.
No, but Earl, I love Earl. Earl's lobster rolls are like better than anything I've had in Boston.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he's fantastic.
I have yet to have the lobster
barrels.
Roll. I tell you what. And yes, despite all the shenanigans that Thomas Ray does, it's a very good spot.
Oh yeah,
so, yes.
best burgers in town.
This is gonna be something where all three judges, you guys are gonna be blindfolded, possibly handcuffed, maybe just you.
Okay.
And then we're gonna decide finally after all of this turmoil who the chicken sandwich winner is.
The smack talk has been amazing.
Isn't it?
I die.
All these
I
ants,
am rolling I laughing. You, it's so good.
People with small hands. I don't know. But let's go into a little bit about you from Kauai, but you went to University of Arizona.
I did.
Mm-hmm. And what year did you grad?
2006.
Okay, not dating you or anything like that. You're still young.
Yeah.
And then you went to D.C.
I did.
Right, so then you...
Well, I mean, I graduated and then I moved here and I worked in news here a little bit.
KGMB, right.
Yes.
Okay.
KGMB, when Hawaii News Now was KGMB and KHNL, two separate entities
right,
at the
right,
time.
Right.
Yeah. And then, I went to D.C. for 5 years and I worked in Capitol Hill for a little while.
Wow.
And, moved back home.
So what...
Here
what
I am.
So back on it with, and then shout out, good friend of the show, Rick Blangiardi.
Oh, yes.
Yes,
Is he really?
He is a good friend, believe it or not.
Then I have to watch what he says.
Well,
that changes everything.
Who knows what he watches?
He was one of the first guests, right?
Who knows?
He was one of your first guests.
He was here.
Was he really?
When we did the show at Square Barrels. See how it all ties in?
Oh, my
We did the show at Square Barrels. He was the guest at Square Barrels.
Was he swearing and everything? I bet
he was. He was melancholy. He was fine.
Okay.
But he was fine.
All right.
But,
he's the best boss ever.
He's a great man. He's still working sharp as ever.
Yes.
You're in D.C., so I got to ask you, do you think Tulsi got a shot at this whole thing?
I mean, she's polling really low.
Yeah. Would it be like the next? Do you think there's any shot possibility? Because she's trying to get her name out there.
It's very unlikely.
Yeah.
Very unlikely. Yeah.
Oh, well. But then...
But you know what? She's made a name for herself, and she's probably... gonna get some gig as like some commentator on Fox News or CNN, so you're gonna see her.
The pay is good.
Yeah,
the pay is well.
It's not the end of Tulsi after this. There's
right.
no way. Yeah.
So what would be your title? As we all know that you're on the air, you also are a producer as well.
No producing.
Okay.
Yeah, just strictly reporting and some fill-in anchoring here and there.
Oh, gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How's Kiahi Tucker doing? Is he still,
he's great.
He's all right.
He's a funny boy too.
Yeah. Gotta just check. How's Joe Beth doing, too?
Joe's good. So I don't see her as much because she's on the Hi Now show. Yeah. So it's a completely different department than me. Yeah. We used to sit 5 feet away from each other. And now she's in a completely different floor. And,
right.
Yeah.
You guys party a lot, though. You guys are always out on the town. I mean, I'm sure after, you know, Pahana, you know, you go down. When's the last time you've been to Pig and the Lady? You still go down there?
It's been a while.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Ever since Kiaka left. Because Kiaka's yeah, he was my boy. But no, I go to Piggy Smalls a lot.
Okay.
To get my fix there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So what's your spots? Of, a lot of stuff has opened up in the past year. What are your go-tos that you
Well,
into?
For brunch, Smith and Kane's, because Samantha puts up with us for hours. No, we're literally there from brunch to lunch to happy hour to dinner. To late happy hour. Like, she just lets us.
She didn't mention that.
Oh, no. We are there all day. Okay. And she doesn't mind. And that's fantastic.
Wow. Yeah. Mimosas all over the place. Yeah.
All day.
Avoid the Navy semen. Yeah, from a previous.
When I heard that.
Right.
She never told me that.
Before. Oh, yeah?
No.
Oh, yeah. How stupid was that?
I was furious.
Right? The semen giving you trouble. What's the matter with these guys?
Yeah. I was furious.
Unbelievable.
She's lucky I wasn't there that day.
Right. Semen drinking mimosas. Gosh. Okay. Well, before we get to the chicken war, let's play a little quick game here.
Okay.
We do on the show. It's a fun one that we do with our guests. It's called Five Questions.
Okay. Oh, boy.
And,
you're going to ask
gonna
me questions?
Something out. I'll try, this and then we're going to see what happens. Yeah. And then, of course, you know, you want to get 5 out of 5 for this one, for respect. That's something that we all want in life. So first question, we'll start with geography. In your best koi pigeon.
Oh, boy. My pigeon.
Explain to myself and to all of us how you get to Hawaii News Now from the Hi Brau Room. You still have that in you. Have you ever spoke pidgin?
Okay, so I look really dumb when I speak pidgin. Like, people
don't
believe
we all?
They don't believe I'm from Kauai because I can't do it.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's go. You got it.
Okay, so let me think where I am. Okay. So.
Good start.
Great start already.
Good start.
You know the federal courthouse over there. You're going to take one left, and then you're going to go ever bound on Nimitz, go past downtown, the Chinatown area where you get your papayas and all that. And then...
And all that, Ali.
You're going past the Young Brothers area where Young your brothers. Uncle goes, he went to Stevedore over there, yes? And then you make one left.
You're on a roll here. You're almost done. You're like, you're right there.
Then take a right on Waya Camilo. You can see the uncles over there working on the sewer. Yeah, they're not going to let you turn left. But anyway, you're going to make one U-turn over there. And then you're going to go.
You're there.
And you're there.
You said Waya Camilo. Okay.
That is correct. That is correct. Yes.
I don't. Yeah. I
pulled
have no
it off there.
Street cred when
well,
it comes to
Well, you came through in the clutch on that one.
Thank you.
Question number two. Let's go from geography to chemistry.
Oh, gosh.
Name the Japanese physicist and pioneer of Japanese physics during the Meiji period.
Why am I supposed to know this?
You're going to know this. You're going to know this.
Can you repeat the question?
Sure.
Chemist.
Name the Japanese physicist.
Oh, physicist.
And pioneer of Japanese physics during the Meiji period.
Why would I know this?
You're going to know this.
Give me a hint.
It's closer to you than you think. Is that a hint, really?
It's like your grandpa or something.
Freeze, do you
Freeze,
know?
Freeze, are you like, that was a good hint, Freeze.
What did, is it Nagaoka something?
Yes, thank you for people throwing things out in the crowd.
Oh, really?
Yes. It is Nagaoka, yes. It is Professor Nagaoka.
Okay.
We'll give you that one because, you know, with outside lifeline. Okay, 2 for 2. Question number 3, being that it's the Christmas season, in the song The 12 Days of Christmas,
the Hawaiian version?
The American version, good call.
Okay.
What is given on the 7th day? See, don't we always just do that? We're just going to whisper the song. Whisper the song.
Something swimming. Swans are swimming. 7 swans are swimming.
You are correct. Wow, in the clutch.
Ooh. Nice.
Nice.
What's the Hawaiian version?
I have no idea. Well, like Passion Orange.
Six.
Something. Big Bad Guava. Okay, got it. Thanks, Jane Heads. Question number 4, another Christmas question.
Okay.
tying into your journalism background, what popular holiday song was written during the Cuban Missile Crisis and was a plea for peace?
What year was that?
This was in the 70s. Early 70s. Do you have a, you have something? You have something.
Pee for please.
If somebody in the crowd got this, that's impressive. Christmas song? It is a Christmas song.
A very popular Christmas song? Like, I don't know it?
It's not the top. I mean, it's the second tier.
Okay.
The second tier, if I say it, you're going to be like, shit. Ugh. And then you're going to get it.
Joy to the World?
Very close.
Can I guess?
Close. You,
Sky, is it John Lennon?
Who?
Is it John Lennon?
No? No, is that the song?
Oh.
What? It was nice. Once again,
the head honcho.
No, I was just guessing myself. What is it?
Yes.
What is it?
Okay, do you hear what I hear?
Oh.
There you go. That's right. Thomas will sing that later. And then we're going to have to give you that one a 3 out of 4. But for question number 5, spell Blangiardi.
B-L-A-N-G-I-A-R-D-I.
You got it. That's why you work there. Correct. Yes.
Love you, well boss. Done.
4 out of 5.
If you're watching.
Would that be something?
I know.
Oh, my goodness.
I know.
Who knows what he's doing right now at like 9 o'clock? But we got. Let's get things going here because we got a big thing. The turmoil will come to an end after all these years of IGing. So, yes, we're going to get ready for the chicken sandwich battle.
Everybody's
here. Let's
with
do it. Let's
blindfolds.
Take a break. Blindfolding, handcuffing. Who knows what's going to happen?
Blindfolding, that's going to... All right.
Fifty Shades of Chicken.
That'll be fine. Yes. Let's take a break here. Sleep time's over. Ashley Nagaoka, everybody. Let's go. All right. And now we are back. It is time that we've all been waiting for. All of it's going to come to an end. But before we do so, we pick somebody out of the crowd. And here he is. Your name, sir?
RJ.
And where are you from?
Minnesota.
Wow, Minnesota. Gopher. Give it up for RJ, everyone. He is the special, special audience judge. And let's also shout out a friend of the show, Jimmy Tacos here, everyone. Hey! Jimmy Tacos Tacos. Jimmy Tacos Tacos at Chingu. You just did the last one just this past Tuesday, last one of the year.
Yes.
And back January 7th?
7th.
Okay, got it. Yes.
Big birthday celebration on that.
Nice. Wow. So figure this is, we got, Ashley's back.
Yes, hi, Ashley.
Okay. All right. So now this is how we're going to do it. We're going to do blindfold style. Everyone's going to put on their designated blindfold. And, you got the kind of matches your shirt, RJ. And then, right? Okay, everybody's going to be put them on. We're going to get sandwich number one ready. Sandwich number one we're going to get this ready here. And sandwich number one person is going to get it. I can't see. Don't fall down. This is the first time we've ever done this. So who knows what's going to happen? We have sandwich number one. And it's going to be right in front of you guys here. And okay, you got it. Oh, this is gonna be, yeah. Let's leave it there. Yeah. So let's disqualify sandwich number one there. That's a great strategy. exactly. Sandwich one gets a minus point there. Okay. Taco, you ready? You can. It's right in front of you. So just go with it. Okay. Ashley's got it. Just take a bite, Taco. Just take a bite here. I tell you what.
This is not awkward at all.
No, it's... I'm just...
Also, it's like you look to see what you're eating.
That's true. That's true. You have a very stressed out Holly. All right? He's a very stressed out Holly man. You don't want to piss off the Holly people. I'm just staring at Ashley. I don't even know what else you guys are doing right now.
A quiet audience.
Right? Holly's kids.
Once again,
this turned into the bro show from last week, the swearing. Shout out Kamaaina for saying fuck and shit. We got. Ironically, Thomas was on the bro show a couple weeks ago. Okay, we done with the bites. Just take a couple bites here. We good? Just so you can get an idea of what's going on.
And then can we get water for Taco and Ashley here? Can we get so we can clear the palate here? Can the Lord get some water?
Can I have the leftovers?
Can someone stop IG storing and get them some water so we can clear the palate? I know everybody wants to boomerang this shit, but you know, we need to clear the palate. I know everyone's IGing and adding. You're eating though, Taco. You got
use
it.
Your shirt.
You got it. Ashley, you're going. You're like, you're sticking yourself in the middle. There you go.
Yes.
See, when you're a deprived man, much like Thomas is,
distressed.
There are not. You just opened up. You stuck your finger in the middle, which I'm watching. I'm really just watching you, so I really don't know what's going on. We're getting water for you guys. I will get the water to you, so don't worry about that. You guys are officially done with sandwich number one here. Are we good? Yeah. Okay, good.
Drop the leftovers.
Okay, we got
right
ratings.
Here.
Okay, we'll get the. Thank you, Janez. We'll clear sandwich number one. And now we got go into the glass there. Yes, make sure they grab the glass. Once again, we've never done this before. This is something, huh? Isn't this something? Okay, we're drinking water, and then yes, you put. This is gonna look great visually, isn't it? Right? Gosh, I need to edit this quick. And then, we have water here. I got you water here. Water will be in the front in case you need it, but in case you need it, just let me know. I put it away from you here. All right, can we get sandwich number two? Sandwich number two. Who is sandwich number? Who wants to be sandwich number two? Well, we can't really say that because that kind of gives it. Never mind any of that. Can we get sandwich number two on, please? Sandwich number two, wherever that may be. Once again, we've never done this before. This is intriguing, isn't it? Okay, very good. All right. I'll put the right here. You have the sandwich right here. That's what she said. Uh-huh. And then we do this here. Okay, we got it.
Definitely take the
Well, it could be that's what he said. That could be that's what she said. Once again, it's the first time we're doing this. The chicken sandwich battle. If you want to hashtag this. Whoa, that was exciting. That was exciting. I got the water. Okay. I got your water. Oh, that was something. That's a commercial bite right there.
That is a
Taco,
bite.
That's a. Shall I lunge like this?
You're not supposed to eat the plate.
Serious gourmet shit.
See, RJ's having no problem with this. He's just eating. He's just living his best life. I'm just staring at Ashley yet again, and it's something. This has been weird since moment one. So yes.
It's been weird since I put on this zebra.
Well, but you're wearing black. It matches. So how are we doing? Just keep biting away here. Take a couple more bites, and then we can clear the palate for sandwich number three.
Bacon!
Hey, all right. Hey. Yeah. Hashtag bacon.
I'm hungry.
So I like your strategy, Ashley, because like you take a bite, and then you go to the middle. That's like a lot of stuff in life, isn't it? Okay, so. Oh, okay.
Okay. This is the chicken sandwich challenge.
This is, once again, in case you've just joined us, this is the chicken sandwich challenge. Hashtag, what's the hashtag for this shit? H&L, Chicken Wars, 2019. Okay, bacon's good. Okay. Once again, can we get napkins? It's kind of like we left you guys out to die. Huh? It's like, no water, no napkins. Place a... Hey, or Baby Yoda reference. Place that we have. Give you guys a place to live. Can we get napkins?
We got towels.
And then, okay. So then I'm gonna take the sandwich away.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Don't eat that.
And then,
thanks, Breeze.
Okay. So yeah, wipe clearly. Then I'll proceed to give you guys the palate cleanser here.
It's whack.
See, even when you wipe, it's great. See. It's, no, I'm going to get that to you. I'm going to get that to you. Okay, so here we go.
Oh, that
it's still, yes.
I like it.
Oh, that has a kick. Okay, so now we have the water. Water is in front of you. Right here. Here you go. Here you go.
talking about.
Like, we already saw the sandwich.
Right. Okay, Taco, I got the water right in front of you. Put your hands out in front of you, and it's going to be right here, here. There you go. RJ, here we go. Here's your water right there. Yes. All right, so now can we clear sandwich two? Is it possible? Is anybody available to clear sandwich two? You know, as Okay. Did someone stick something in someone's? Okay. All right, just checking. All right. And now let's go for the third and final sandwich. Hopefully you've locked your scores in for sandwich number two. We have sandwich three. Watch out the water down there. And okay, a little bit more complicated, guys. You guys got a container. You got the container. Here we go. There's for you. Okay, Taco, you got it. You got the containers. Sandwiches right there. There we go. Gosh, this is like Saw. You guys know the movie Saw? You guys remember that? Remember, it's like, this is like Saw, like, you know, After Dark, you know, where there's no intercourse. It's just, you know, they're just touching. Doesn't this remind that of you guys? Yeah. See, that's a line that they could use.
Get it, girl.
All right. Once again, you got. Once again, in case you haven't figured it out by now, we're on sandwich three. We have Ashley's going with this, the same style she's done for sandwich one and two. She takes a couple bites and then she goes into it.
That's how yummy. You do it.
Right? Taco, you're getting this figured out. You're the biting for this one is really on point. You got it figured out. But for the third one, of course, you know. Oh, sorry, Taco. RJ's having no problem. He's just living his best life over here. Okay, once again, Ashley, you're sticking in the middle. Okay, all right. So you can take one more bite there, Ashley, and then. That's right. Taco, how you doing? You good? Okay, you good? RJ, you good? Okay, good. You got it down. You got it down. Okay, so time for water. Okay, so here we go. RJ, you good? Okay. For some reason, Taco's water disappeared. And then, oh, you got it? Can we make sure Taco gets the water? Wow, he got it. Was that rigged? Okay. Okay, Ashley, here we go. Here's your water. All right. So after you guys take the water, then we're going to finally unmask. Finally. Because that was the... That's a three. That was a three. Okay. So we'll take this. We'll put this away. Not yet. Actually, we have to take these away. Take these away. Very good. Okay, now you guys can unmask. All right. Wow. That was fun, wasn't it? Huh? Oh. Gosh. That was a chore. Okay, so now let's go into... We might have one in the back. How you doing? All right. Everybody's stressed out. RJ is just having a ball with this thing. Okay. All right. So let's tally it up. Now we had three. Let's go down the line. RJ, closest to me. Which one of the three did you enjoy the most?
That's tough. One and two are definitely both seasoned very well. But three had a good complex to it. So.
Oh. RJ.
Wow. The word complex.
Taking the fact that like they were cooked however long ago. One was still pretty crispy. What are you gonna like, top one?
The top one?
Yeah. I have to say number two.
Oh! Number two, all right, number two it is. All right, as I lunge over, Ashley, of the three.
They're all good. I like that two had bacon. Number one was crispy. I agree with that. It was definitely the crispiest. But three, no question, was my favorite. The chicken, just the sauce on it, and the bun, and it had enough acid from the pickles. I felt like number one didn't have enough acid. It just felt like chicken and bread. But three was amazing. I could have ate the whole thing.
Wow. All right, voting for three. All right, so we got a vote for two.
vote for three. Taco, no pressure. Who did you pick?
Out of the three, I would actually say the second one was my favorite.
Yes.
Yeah. I do like Texas toast. I'm a big fan of, like, you know, thick bread.
That's it! We won! We won! It's over!
We won! You see what you caused here, Taco?
I did have a couple more things to say, but it's okay. It's all right, I guess.
When you deal with Holly people.
We're calling him out. We're calling him out.
You know.
A soldier.
First they took the land. Now they took the chicken sandwich. Wow.
That's right. Can we Captain Cook this guy out?
We could definitely. And batter him up too. Throw him in the fryer.
We got one downstairs. What do you guys want to know the thoughts on?
All three sandwiches were amazing. Amazing. I did like the sauce on the third sandwich as well, but two was my joy.
Nice. Okay. Well,
there you have it. The white man wins again. Square Barrels wins it. Square Barrels is the champion. That was number two, Texas Toast. So once again, Square Barrels, you're not even the shot. Sit down. Sit down over your shop.
Justin, give me a shot. Give me a shot.
I don't think we can offer it up.
Sit on daddy's lap.
That's not going to happen.
Thomas, this is your moment.
Yeah. Justin, is this good enough? Right here? Right here? All right. I'm down. I'm pumped. All right, first of all, shout out to Justin. Love the guy. Even though he has small raccoon hands. They're super small. Second of all, shout out to the judges and their excellent palates. And third of all, Butcher and Bird, with your emo logo, we're coming after you for the McRib Off. Justin and I are doing the next McRib Off. Whatever shit you're doing, we're gonna do it better. All right?
I didn't even know it was a McRib Off. Wow, that was great. Wow. All right. Well, three was Earl Kakaako. Yes. Yes. Smith & Kings was one, Squares two, Earl Kakaako three. So there you have it. 2019 chicken. Well, let's take a break, huh? let's give a hand though to everyone. DJ Jimmy Taco, Ashley Nagaoka, RJ for coming in the clutch here. Huh? Let's go. We still got IA performing next, three times over. Let's take a break.
Indeed. The brother from Square Barrels, man, he's hype.
Yeah, you. Next time you gotta come party in Waianae, Nanakuli with us.
Yeah.
That's okay, we take care of him. We'll put the halo over him.
And believe it or not, we are still on. And we're not done yet because we got Mr. Kamaaina Classic himself. He's back. IA.
What's up,
everybody? Back on the show, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.
Did you know that there's a gazelle behind you? Oh, is that a gazelle?
We tried to figure that out. I don't really know the name.
Is it a marsupial?
The Lord knows this. The marsupial? Really?
Is that a marsupial? I'm from Nanakuli. What does marsupial mean?
I wish I could tell you. I don't know. Once again.
A beaver?
We cover all ground with this show. We're as diverse as possible. But yes, friend of the show. Once again, thank you for coming, man.
No, of course. Thank you. No, I appreciate it. Thank you for having me.
And you just had a new song. Just came out. New video.
Yes.
Talk to us about that.
The new song is called Hard to Beat. It's a dedication to all of Hawaii's past and present champions.
Yeah.
And it's just an anthem because, like Ash was saying earlier, there's so much crazy stuff going on right now. And yes. I feel like in Hawaii, you know, we're in a time where we should be celebrating. It's a time for us to celebrate our successes. You know what I mean? Some stuff we had success with recently in the past. And just enjoy.
Right.
You know, being from Hawaii, being local. Right. You know what I mean? So
they got you in Aloha Stadium. How'd you pull that off? You just walk in?
I had to tell my uncle was Aaron Sakai.
That's not going to get you anywhere in there.
DJ Jimmy Taco.
That'll get you somewhere.
Trust me,
yes.
It was not easy getting inside Aloha Stadium.
Of course not.
You had to jump through some crazy
things. Rust galore. I mean, I don't know how you did it, but you stayed in the middle of the field. So
it did help Dad. Thank you. It does help that Jesus the Hawaiian Punch is your dad. So.
That's right. Yes. That's right. How's Dad doing?
Dad is good. I mean, you know.
Good stuff, man. I tell you, so any performances coming up based off the new video?
No, just this one right now is the only one I'm worried about. So last performance of 2019, we had a crazy year.
Right, last performance of the 2010s, man.
2010s.
We're in the decade with you.
Yes. You know, we were in Asia this past summer, California, West Coast tour with Leia Love.
Oh, nice.
And we're going to end it off 2019 and the decades here on Sleep Time's Over.
And this is your first time performing on the show. Now, you've been on the show several occasions, but you've never performed on the show. So this is going to be a treat. Once again,
I'm excited.
Hey, let's do it.
A little bit different crowd, too, than what I'm used to.
Yes.
Let's do this, though. How's everybody doing tonight? You guys feeling good? DJ Freeze, let's go. Shout out to the Lord Floors. I didn't get to hear my intro. We're going to do it like this. This song is called Hard to Beat. Dedicated to Hawaii. Can we turn it up a little bit? Yeah. If I'm not the best, then I'm hard to beat. Hard work, hardly sleep. I am who I am. I be who I be. And because of that, ain't nobody changing me. Y'all said, ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody checking. Yeah. I ain't gotta say more. My attitude says it best. You don't know where I'm from? I let my lingo do the rest. Yes, you're now rocking with the best. 10 fingers down, man, I'm taking all bets. You, and you to the left. I'ma take it all straight up, no jest. Now it's a light flex, I might next. Hit him with the right, left. You know the kind, right? The type your girl likes. Same type everybody in the world likes. Yeah, I'm the product of this lifestyle. Meanwhile, you know we got them eyes now. From the church to the ring now. From the ocean to the screen now. You better sing it loud. If I'm not the best, then I'm hard to beat. Hard work, hardly sleep. I am who I am, I be who I be. And cause of that, ain't nobody changing me. I said, ain't nobody, nope. Ain't nobody changing me. 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 Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody changing me. Second verse right here is my favorite. Yeah, get your hands up, cause this be the anthem. Why you mad? Cause I'm pully and I'm handsome. So, what more can I say? The HI is the reason that I act this way. In that case, I do this for my culture. This be Hawaii when it's not on a postcard. You could dance too, cause the beat go hard. Act hard and catch his hands in the front yard. Yeah, I do it for the team. Everywhere I go, you know that everything's green. Yeah. I get it for my town. When them lights go on, it's about to go down. Better get your phones out, cause you can't slow down. It's all good now, like we out the hood now. You want it? I got it. Dripping like water. Sipping on kava, turn a hater into nada. If I'm not the best, then I'm hard to beat. Hard work, hardly sleep. I am who I am, I be who I be. And cause of that, ain't nobody changing me. I said, ain't nobody, nope. Ain't nobody changing me. Ain't nobody, nope. Ain't nobody changing me. Since we got that ring light, check on my shirt. I got it from the swap meet. 5 for $20. But y'all, check us out. My name is IA. Follow me on all your social media platforms at IA808. Big mahalo to Sleep Time's Over, DJ Zach Morris, my man Sky Cameron, the rest of the crew. But for real though, mahalo for creating community. Because you know what they say, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go farther, go together. Hawaii Hip Hop, IA, from Manakuli to Honolulu. You know how we do. Hard to be out now. Yeah.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. We got to get out of here. Sleep Time's over. Let's thank Sky Cameron. KO on the boards.
Yes.
We have to thank the sponsors. We have to thank Sakai and Company with the Christmas cupcake thing. Calamense. I don't know what it's called. Calamansi. It's Christmas. It's green and red. Let's thank them. Ashley Nagaoka finally coming on here. Yeah. How about it? All right. Good Lord. DJ Jimmy Taco. Where is he at? He's still here. Okay. He's going to get lit real shortly. Let's thank Earl Kakaako, Smith & Kings for being here. Let's thank
the winner,
Square Barrels, for being here. Thomas Ray. Everybody, let's get out of here. Yeah. IA, anything, any shout-outs last minute? That's it?
DJ Freeze. Yeah. Freeze. Rapper, you said it all. Shout out Nana Cooley.
Hey.
Shout out to people not dying in Hawaii. All right. Shout out Jay Naz. We out of here. Sleep time's over.
Thank you for listening to Sleep Time's Over. Time's over. No sleeping tonight. No sleeping tonight. No sleeping tonight.